So let's just take this for an example, Robert. You know, we live in a different age today. You know, we feel like we are eons away from the Holocaust and from human slavery and de jure segregation. We have never been more sophisticated and never been more advanced. You know, sometimes when I fly and they tell us we're 40,000 feet in the air, I said, America is such a technological genius. Look at how much we've progressed. Then I look again and I said, and we're just as dangerous and deadly as we are innovative. Why today, with all that we've learned from the past in history, do we still want to make judgments about people based on the hue of their skin, maybe about their hair, about where they live? Why? Does it make us feel better? Is it we're trained to do so? We're still in many ways uncivilized.
Well, you know, the same arguments that you just made were made in the 18th century. The same arguments you just made were made by Socrates in ancient Greece. People find ways to separate themselves, whether it's ethnically, whether it's racially, whether it's on the basis of religion. People find ways to separate themselves and to discredit another group as simply being not part of who we are. And this is the problem when people use racism and bigotry and prejudice interchangeably, because they're different words because they have different meanings. It is not the question of changing people's individual personal feelings towards groups. It's changing the effects that they can have on the lives of those other individuals. So it's one thing to say, well, I have issues with Hispanic people just because of their race. That's a presidential thought. It's another thing to say, I'm going to build a wall between our countries and make sure they can't get public assistance if they're here based upon their race, and not ascribe that to other groups and say we want more people from Norway here. That's racism. So we have to understand that as long as people separate themselves along ethnic, racial, socioeconomic, religious lines, that we're going to have this invidious nature where people are judged based upon the group they are placed into and not based upon their individual characteristics.